गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इट्स द टाइम फॉर ट्रेड प्लान फॉर 1st of June 2020. द US मार्केट्स वर डाउन इन द अर्ली पार्ट ऑफ द डे, बट फाइनली रिकवर्ड एंड क्लोज्ड हायर, एटलीस्ट ऑन द S&P एंड NASDAQ. नाउ for the day I expect that the Nifty is likely to cross the package day high, which was about 9580 thereabouts on the futures. So it's a buy on dip market as far as I am concerned, although we are going to have a fourth up day. So support zone for the day is 9400 to 9440, and resistance comes in at 9523 to 9563. We are going to open above all of these levels as far as the SGX Nifty at 6:40 a.m. is concerned. So, you know, if we kind of hold this 9520, 9560 zone, then we should expect that the Nifty moves higher from this level, and chances are that the discount only helps the Nifty on the upside. The Bank Nifty support zone is 18747 to about 18892. Resistance zone is 19182 to about 19327. Again, chances are we are going to open above all of these zones, and you know, if you come back into this 19182 to about 19347, you would like to buy. So this broadly gives you the roadmap for the day. What is critical is, do not buy the first tick above these levels. Wait, see if the market comes off, then again moves higher, which means that you start to find support at higher levels. Because it shouldn't be the case that the market traps you at higher levels and then comes off because, you know, you didn't wait enough to buy when the market action clearly becomes supportive. Overall, I think the May rally should continue on the upside, and a retest of 9900, 10,000 seems to be on the cards, and the rally may be surprising. Why? Because nobody expects it. Everybody thinks this is some kind of, you know, fake rally. So the sense is that, you know, all kinds of declines, particularly on financials, because chances are financials could lead this sort of rally. Last week you had a big positive bar, and this week, you know, you are getting follow through. So that's going to surprise and shock a lot of people. And this is where, you know, the 200 day moving average comes in. Remember that video of a 4:1 trade and the 9400 call? This is what was expected. It took a while, but now that it's begun to happen, you could be very surprised how soon and how fast the market gets to 9900 to 10,000. Again, we are trading so far below the equilibrium, which is the 200 day moving average, that the market is getting attracted back to those levels. So all those retest theorists, chances are their retest theory of 7500 may not play out, okay? But that shouldn't bother any of us. Why? Because if 7500 comes, we will make money. If 11,000 comes, we will make money. So a view is a view is a view. Do not fall in love with your view. Okay. For the moment, we are heading up, and all you have to do is try to buy into support and hang in there and see what sort of upside starts to develop. We are going to start our opening up process today. Again, the cases are rising with or without the lockdown opening, but while the government says it's ready, the news from hospitals is something different. But it appears that people are quote unquote managing. So corona news is likely to get worse, but surprisingly the market is likely to head higher. Okay, so make sure that you participate in this rally and try to do it at congestion zones and when the market corrects, instead of trying to chase or getting stuck in the mud where you buy just when the market gets into a consolidation. This is a very day trading type of view. For a swing trader, you have to buy with a stop say around 9500 and then hold on. There is nothing else to do. I would think you should have another green weekly bar, and that will help you to go up. Large private sector banks should see more upside. Reliance could see more upside. I would think even IT could participate on the upside. So it will be a fairly, across the board style rally. So possibly defensives, etc., may be a little subdued. But overall, I would think even the pharma, FMCG stocks on their day will do well. So basically, this should be your opening up rally, which we are trying to play into. Economic news is bad, will remain bad. I think the market is now looking past, this March to July quarter, which it has written off. So what we have to play for is that we open up, and the opening up is not too bad. Even if we are able to recover, say, 60-70% of pre-COVID sales, etc., and you know, people lose their fear of going out, that is what the market is trying to look for. That should be it for the day. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.